Yo, what's going on, man? What's happening?
Lights in the station had me shaking. Conversation with the police like talking with pagans. Long circle trip start had me raging. They threw me in the scraps on the main ring. That's A-ring.
I just wanted to find out, like, more about yourself. Like, how did you get started in rap?
All the family members, people from the area, used to go, like, sound clashes and that. When my godfather was a mad sound clashing guy, called Platinum Cartel, used to go by, little rage and dance, and I kind of picked up from there, if that makes sense. So I was more like an instruments guy back then.
Right.
You know what I mean? You know what, first, yeah, I wanted to be like, I always thought I'd be a grime rapper. You know what I mean? Kind of like a Dizzy Basketball that used to get me, so solid that. Like, I used to feel them, so I thought it would be grime, but it didn't work out like that. Then, rap started, I wouldn't say drill, but before the drill. So like hood rap, I'll call it. Started, everyone started rapping from the areas. It was just like an area thing then, you know what I mean? Like, then drill started, I thought, you know what? It's the same kind of thing, but a different kind of beat. Me personally, I'm more feel the drill beats over any other beat. But I don't mean that I'm gonna go on the drill beat and the drill, you know where I'm coming from. It's just an easier beat to go. When I started rapping, I used to get rattled up all the time. I couldn't really get there. I couldn't write. I could write like four bars and I'll stop. I'd go away for like 3 days, come back, write another four bars. My mum get some next bars, but I put them together and it worked. But then, that was more like a storytelling.
Right.
So I want to think about it, try to put two metaphors in there and switch out, make you listen a bit more. But when it came to drill, it was a whole thing that it was easy because, like, it's the life that I was living at the time and I'm just putting it into words. Do you know what I mean? Like, instead of you take and writing a rap song and doing some whole thing, you go studio, the drill beats on, this happened, that happened. It's just there, it's flowing. It's like it came more natural, if that makes sense. Like, it's just flowing, innit?
Literally. There's a lot of discussions about drill, right? Because some people are like, you know, condemn it straight away and are just like, they're against it because, you know, it's pretty vivid. Some would say that if things weren't going on the street, you wouldn't be getting mad to that in the first place.
Literally.
What's your take on that situation?
They say that here, but I look at that, like my friends have been up here, like Americans have been doing it for a long time. Police have always been cracking down on it. Like, they're just reflecting on how they were brought up, and it's like someone that's been through heartache or problems, they're going to do some love songs. Like, you grew up in the era where I grew up on, you might do, you never know, you could do classical music. But you might express it in a different way, do you know what I mean? You might want to play the drums and you start whacking with the shit out of the drum. Like.
Right.
It all depends on how you express, but the drill, I don't know, man, it's just cave, innit? You know what I mean?
Right.
Like, it's never a way to express how you was feeling and what was going on. But then again, at the same time, like, if drill never came about as much as it did, then people wouldn't be paying as much attention to like, what's really going on.
Right.
Because now, certain drill artists and rappers, what they're saying, they're bringing more attention and life, like police are paying more attention. The government's actually looking at certain things like, hold on, this person's actually going out doing that, they're rapping about it, what's actually going on here? So now they're looking more into what's actually bringing them from them areas that makes sense, you know where I'm coming from.
Is that good or bad?
50-50, innit? Works both ways, innit? Like, it'll be good because people are actually trying to help them, but then on the other hand, does that person really want the help that they're given? They chose that part because they feel like they wasn't given the help in the first place. So yeah, they want to express their feelings. And then,
How do you feel? Because you got a crazy reputation. There's a lot of things people are saying, and then it's weird that you know there's other people that I know that have been, they'll look at a Twitter account and be like, oh, he's about this and he's about that, and I'm like, that's a cool guy. That's how it is. A cool guy. I don't know none of that.
Like, it's such a facade, isn't it? It's like a job. Like certain business is a job, innit? So you can't always take everyone at face value. If that makes sense. Like certain people might
entertain.
Yeah. So certain people might talk the most, but they're not actually living that life. So never ever take a person. So people might say, "Wow, that guy's there. He's scary." But like you said, the mood is like, "Oh, sure, he's actually a nice guy. You just need to get to know him." People judge you by that. Like you say, judge book by judge by. Don't judge a book by its cover.
Right.
And that's what a lot of people do with drawers. And you look at history and past tense and think that's how you're going to be forever. You know what I mean? But it's not really that though, isn't it?
From when you first started out, from when you did your first little joint to where you are now, like, where's your head at now? What do you want now moving forward?
I want to do some counter music. Like, it's more like change, isn't it? You don't want people to go in that same path or situation. But it just leads to worse things, you know what I'm from. Like, it's like a circle of events that's just gonna keep on going. Until someone breaks it or goes a different route. But then you might go a different route, it don't always work out for you. It all depends on the situation and the person and what your mind frame is, like you said, isn't it?
Do you feel the responsibility of being a role model?
I would rather be seen as a guy that's doing drill or done drill and changed up and done something better than that guy that's done drill for his whole life. And yeah, people just go on what the government says, isn't it? Literally.
How do you feel about being judged by past relationships or your past in general, given where you're at now and you're moving forward?
You know what? Some people will always judge you in your past, and that will forever be normal. Like, I've learned that through life in general, what you get. And you can never ever take that. Like, see that? Me, I take that as a good thing, innit? Like, you need to be talking about me, even if it's a negative way, they still give you free publicity. And that's how I've always seen it. So, them negative comments, energy, don't be phase me. I just push it to the back and just keep progressing in what I'm doing right now. Yeah.
You posted something crazy on Twitter.
Me? Nah. I ain't got Twitter.
Really?
This is the funniest thing. I ain't got Twitter. I ain't got Facebook.
Hold on, so that's not your Twitter account?
I ain't got no Twitter.
Serious?
No Twitter, no Facebook, nothing.
Really?
Keep on getting told I've got Twitter. I even got a LinkedIn page and I never use LinkedIn.
Really?
Like, it's crazy. But that would probably be that. But that page there, I've seen it myself now.
Right.
And it's over 5 or 6 years old.
Really?
It's not even a new page.
Right.
And the photo that's on there is way of, because I know that photo.
Right.
Yeah.
So what, you think some kind of weird fan set it up or something? No, is it?
Hopefully not a weird person, but yeah.
You know what I mean? Alright, it's a person. I don't want to know, you know what I mean? Alright.
But yeah, someone has bored or something there, man.
Yeah, definitely. Right.
But hopefully you can get taken down.
Alright. So what's your plans moving forward?
Bro, we've got this EP with Keep Alive. That's about other music that's coming, no drill. Some new type of music.
How's it feel to say that?
It feels nice, that, because see, like I said before, I used to get rattled, but now when I do certain music, now I feel calm, man, it flows. Like, instead of it being drill, the other way it flows. Yeah, like, it's real life now. You get me, hopefully it helps change, innit? If not, someone's gonna listen to it and feel it. You know what I mean?
But everyone should check out the Keep Alive EP, right?
Definitely, it's gonna be a mad one.
September 3rd.
So you know more than me. You know more than me. Yeah, I didn't even know that. You know more than me, so. But cool, trust me, love,
right.